Hi everyone, welcome to Itsy Bitsy's live read from Rebound by Rowan Shaw. Chapter 1, Adrian. It had been 3 years since I had first met my boyfriend Raphael. 3 years of bliss that began the day he knocked on my front door. Opening my art gallery turned out to be the best decision of my life, too. My sales are high and steady. Creating art was the most freeing job I could ever imagine. After I acquired international clients a little over a year ago, my business grew beyond all expectations. I almost made as much dough as I did with my previous job. I was still traveling more than I liked, but Raphael and I always managed to find time for other precious time that we refused to let anything or anyone disturb. We'd settle down like an old couple, content with our regular routines. I cooked for him every evening. I was home before he grabbed a book and joined me in bed, along with our Siamese cat, Isla, and our French bulldog, Opal. We still lived in the same apartment in the 14th arrondissement of Paris. The walls of our 40-square-meter living room still harbored my colorful paintings and erotic charcoals, but the room that used to be my studio now served as a library for all Raphael's books, and his old bedroom was now the guest room. Sunday was finally here. I was laying in bed wearing nothing but a shirt and some briefs as I patted Isla's soft fur and kept flipping through the channels on our flat-screen TV. Raphael dropped his book in his lap with a sideways glance at me. Are you done yet? What? His beautiful hazel eyes creased. You've been flipping through the channels for 10 minutes. Just choose something already, or I can read to you if you want. I gave a smile and turned the TV off. What are you reading? I scooted closer, but my moves startled Opal, who jumped to her feet at the edge of the bed, then directly on my stomach, knocking the living breath out of me. Curled up against my side, Isla hissed and glared at the dog, ready to mutilate her. Oprah had no survival instincts. She hopped back and forth between Raphael and me, snorting in disregard to our cat's death stare. Annoyed, Isla left the bed, which was exactly what Opal wanted. The dog settled between my lover and me and made the weirdest noises. I never knew dogs could sound like piglets, but apparently French bulldogs did. Raphael petted her black fur, then leaned into me for a kiss that quickly turned ravenous. I wrapped my hand around his neck and pulled him closer, drawing him into me, his plump mouth tasting of spearmint toothpaste as he caressed my tongue with his. With a tiny bark, Opal hopped between us and pushed her head against my neck to lick my throat until her tickles forced me to pull back. Raphael settled against my shoulder to read aloud, and Opal moved to my lap where she curled up and went back to sleep, happy that she managed to interrupt us. The sound of Raphael's deep voice soothed me, making me feel at home wherever we might be. He had let his hair grow over time, so it was now a high taper fad afro, trimmed on the sides and long on top. I loved the shape of his sharp masculine jaw, always clean-shaven, as well as his beautiful fleshy lips, but my favorite part remained his dimples that never disappeared, even when he wasn't smiling. After letting my eyes roam his gorgeous face, I ran my fingers down the length of his arm and let myself enjoy the feel of his soft brown skin. I closed my eyes to listen as the words poured between his lips and nursed me into a light sleep, soon broken by the sound of my beeping phone. Raphael looked at me from the corner of his eye. I thought we agreed no phone in the bedroom. I know, I forgot to turn it off. Sorry. Don't pick it up, he pleaded, and rolled on his stomach and then slipped his hand under my t-shirt and gave me a hungry look. What if it's Celeste? It could be an emergency. I could never stop worrying about my sister, even when I knew she was fine. In spite of the deep sigh whistling through his mouth, Raphael nodded reluctantly. I left a quick peck on his forehead and grabbed his chin to draw him into a long, slow kiss. I'll make it up to you. Take Oprah and Isla out of the room. I haven't fucked you properly since forever. We did it last night, he commented. You made me come twice. Exactly. That was forever ago. I gave a tiny wink and retrieved my phone to stare at the screen. Noah, can I call you? Now, please? I frowned at the urgency in his words. It wasn't like Noah to contact me this late, not since I'd settled down with Raphael, anyway. It's Noah, I told Raphael, when he walked back into the room. Can't you reply later? The beseeching tone of his voice made me hesitate, but Noah wasn't the kind of person to ask for help unless he truly needed it. It sounds urgent. He never texts me like this. Raphael shrugged. But his nonchalance was fake. Even though he never said it out loud, I knew it still bugged him that Noah and I used to fuck. It was always there in the shifting glances he sent us when my best friend was around. I blew my lover an air kiss and gave Noah a call. Hey, what's up? I asked as soon as he picked up. On the other side of the line, loud sound greeted my question as if he were choking. Noah, are you okay? Are you crying? He replied with a sniffle, soon followed by more. He was weeping so hard I couldn't understand a single word he was muttering. Noah, you're scaring me. What's wrong? Hugo. His hiccups were out of control. He broke up with me. What? Why? Noah and his boyfriend had been together for over 10 years. They were already a couple when I first met him. I knew there'd been trouble between them for a while now, but never anything that could possibly tear them apart. I sat up in bed and rubbed my neck. His forehead creasing, Raphael joined my side while Noah tried to breathe in between sobs. Is he there? Are you at your place? I asked. No. His sniffle subsided for a few seconds, only to pick up just as strongly. He left. Can I come to your place? I sent a quick glance at Raphael and covered the phone to whisper. Noah wants to come over. I can't say no. This is really bad. He gave a tiny, reluctant nod. Yes, come over, I said into the phone. Do I need to come pick you up? No, I have my car. You shouldn't be driving when you're this distraught. I'll be fine. Call an Uber, or I'm coming over, I insisted. Can I spend the night? Noah croaked, ignoring my demands. I don't want to be here when he comes back. Yes, of course, you can stay in the guest room, I replied without hesitation. Raphael looked at me pointedly, so I gestured to let him know I'd explain after hanging up. Are you leaving now? I asked. Yes. Are you sure you can get here on your own? I don't want to leave my car here. I'll drive. I knew he shared the vehicle with Hugo, which made me wonder if Hugo had left the apartment on foot or with somebody else. We're here. We'll wait. He choked on another sob and hung up. He's coming here? Raphael asked as soon as I put my phone down on the nightstand table. I'm sorry. I couldn't say no. What's going on? Hugo broke up with him. Raphael stood on the bed and headed to the chest of drawers to rifle through it and put on some pants over his boxers. Why? He asked over his shoulder. I don't know. Noah wouldn't say. They've been having problems for a while. It's nothing new. Because Hugo wants to be monogamous. Yes, among other things. Raphael glanced at me. Care to elaborate? I rubbed my mouth through a sigh. Back when Noah and I were sleeping together, Noah wanted me because Hugo wouldn't give him what he needed. Raphael's wince was subtle but perceptible. Hugo is really rough in bed, I explained. He's never been the tender, affectionate lover Noah always thought. Why did they date so long then? That was a good question but difficult to answer. I think they grew comfortable and got stuck in a rut. Hugo wanted a one-on-one relationship, but Noah isn't the kind of person who does monogamy. You've seen his YouTube channel. His entire mantra is that society needs to stop forcing everyone to conform to its nuclear family values. Yeah, I saw. I'm not fond of his message. Raphael sat on the edge of the bed as he slid a shirt on and turned to look at me. I raised an eyebrow and stood to get dressed. Why not? Because people already think bisexuals are cheats who can't settle down and be trusted. Noah's videos hurt our community. It's better to be honest like Noah than someone who will cheat on their partner any chance they get. There's a difference between being in an open relationship and cheating, Raphael. Bisexuals need to stop acting like being poly is a stain on our community. True, but some people already view queers as deviant. We don't need him to confirm their views. Who gives a fuck what bigots think? I'm tired of us having to act chaste to please biased straights and queers. They are poly people among non-bisexuals too, just so you know. There's nothing wrong with enjoying sex or needing more than one person to fulfill one's emotional needs when it's between consenting adults. You're pretty judgmental for someone who's had threesomes. I would think you'd be a little bit more open-minded. I'm just saying Noah is one of the very few French bisexual YouTubers out there. We don't need to know whom he's fucking and why. He's just playing into what people already think of us. My jaw ticked in spite of myself. Again, who gives a fuck? I sure don't. I don't care what people think of me or other bisexual out there. And neither should you. I don't understand why it bothers so many people that Noah is poly. He's just living his life, for fuck's sake. And if we keep worrying so much about what others think of us, we'll never get to live, Raphael. People will always hate what they don't understand. We might as well just ignore them and be happy. I don't want to get angry over this, and I didn't like when Raphael judged my best friend over something that was none of our concern. Yes, Noah was poly and bi. Yes, he was loud and proud about it. So what? I was sick and tired of the bi community crucifying him just because other people had slapped the cheating label on our backs. This fight to prove them wrong was getting tiresome. I changed the subject when I felt myself getting upset. I didn't want to get into an argument. Pornography was one of those topics Raphael and I disagreed on, which was pretty hypocritical of him, considering how many times he brought up the idea of a threesome. "Will you help me get the guest room ready?" I asked. He gave a nod and stood to help. Through his lips were pursed and his face closed off. I hope he would change his attitude before Noah got here, because I wasn't playing referee tonight. Noah needed my help, and I wasn't about to deny him, just because Raphael still had issues with my past or his own desires. Chapter 2, Raphael. When Noah arrived past midnight, the white skin of his face was swollen and tear-stricken. He had mascara running down his cheeks and dark smudges circling his striking turquoise blue eyes. His blonde hair was a complete mess, as if he tugged at it all evening. When Adrian kissed him on the cheeks and Noah dragged him into a tight hug. I couldn't hear the soothing words my lover whispered in his ear, but Noah gave a short nod before following us to the living room. Adrian was almost one head taller than him. I had to admit, Noah was more than attractive, in a fragile, almost ethereal kind of way. My boyfriend's olive skin was a sharp contrast to Noah's white, pastry white complexion, and while Noah looked 20, I knew he was actually 28. 2 years younger than us. His smooth face contrasted with my boyfriend's more rugged features and the few wrinkles that creased around Adrian's eyes when he laughed. Adrian's constant stubble aged him by 2 years, while Noah was always clean-shaven with perfect, unblemished baby skin. He was so lean. He looked almost skinny in his black clothes, while Adrian chastised and muscular from hitting the gym every morning. The dissimilarity between the two was fascinating to watch, especially when one knew the sexual history they shared. I could never stop wondering what they looked like together in bed, no matter how hard I tried not to envision it. I knew Adrian missed having sex with Noah, even if he never said the words or denied my claims firmly whenever I brought up the subject. I just knew. Thank you for listening to this portion.